Hey everybody, it's your girl Nothing's Impossible 77 straight out of Brooklyn. Yes, as you see in the title, this is the mommy tag. And this is my mama. Y'all know her because mommy, you've been on videos with me since at least, oh my gosh, going back as far as like 3 years or so, right? So say hi to everyone, mama.
Hi.
We're going to do the mommy tag, so let's get right to it. Mommy, you don't have to be like this the whole time. Just relax.
I'm relaxed.
No, mommy, just tell it.
I can't relax.
Yeah, but you're like this. You feel comfortable? You nervous?
Yeah.
I got you on my video. You nervous?
Yeah, I'm not.
Okay, so mommy has absolutely no idea any of the questions that I'm going to ask her. Before I go into the video, I have on my earrings from Bayesian from, Barbadian Beauty. I'll put it in the description so you'll know who it is. But these earrings, actually, they had a lot of long strips on them. And I was trying to, you know, wear them. And I was like, you know, I don't like the strips. You know, it's a little bit too much for me. Because as you can see, I have big eyes. I've got big hair. And I've got a whole bunch of strips. So I took the strips off. And I actually like it. I'm not sure if Miani has any that has without the strips. But I really, really like this. So, yeah. Okay. So, getting right into it, this is the mommy tag. So here are the questions. My mom has absolutely no idea what I'm going to ask her. And it's 16 questions, mama. So let's...
16?
Yeah, 16. So let's get this party started. Yeah. Right.
You were spoiled. Mm-hmm. And you were more... You're more sensible than your age with everything, you know? You always really, you know? But everybody loved you. Everybody, you know, just was excited over you, your grandparents, everybody. So it was like, okay, you know?
I was more advanced than my age?
Yes, very sensible, very, very sensible, okay. Where, which, you know, was like unusual,
okay.
You know? First couldn't understand them because I thought, you know, and they're so truthful and stuff like that, so you know, you kind of, I couldn't understand it, but it was interesting. I like the question. So
when you say truthful, are you trying to say that I am very open about things that normally, you know, back in your day wouldn't have been, so you guys wouldn't have been so open with?
No, because I think we're always very open with you. And you could just about ask anything, say, you know, what's on your mind. And, you know, we always understood that you're just sensible. It was kind of overbearing at times. Mm. Too sensible. But
okay.
Yeah, you were.
Okay.
Wow. Well... After I had your brother, you didn't like the idea very much of him coming to take over where you were, especially with your dad. Mm-hmm. So when we had to pay a lot of attention, you kind of got a little, it was sort of overbearing for you, so you used to hide him. I literally mean hide him under the bed. And we come in the room and where's the and you look at us like, what are we talking about? And he was under the bed. It's not funny. It wasn't funny.
Wow. Mm-hmm.
But that's
how old was my age then?
He's your only, how much older than
Than my brother? Like, I'm like a year and a half older than him. So
yeah.
I was like a year and a half.
Yeah, and sometimes
maybe two.
Sometimes
maybe
you got bitten.
But I used to bite them. You know, I know. I heard about that.
And
one
after
that.
You got slapped a few times for it, then you stopped. But you made it known that I really don't know why this child is here now and taking away everything from your dad and I. So you know, it was kind of like, but it was funny.
I think the story that I remember more than anything is that you said once you were in the kitchen and the next thing you heard this great big scream coming from the room, which was my brother. So when you came in the room, I was just dum, 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 dum. And you were like, what happened? Yes. And I was like,
yes.
And then you said that's when you saw the bite mark on his leg.
Yes. Yeah. So. Yes. And he was so quiet.
Yeah, and chunky. He was chunky,
you know,
too.
He was like, mm-hmm. you could do anything with him and, mm-hmm. and he'd be all right. But Jackie wanted to get rid of him. Mm-hmm. She really did. Mm-hmm. Seriously. I hope he's
that's
watching
funny.
This and he knows
it. I'll send it to him so he can get a good laugh. Yes. Yeah, don't forget what I did to you when you was a baby,
yeah,
son.
I could have finished you off.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah. So that was funny. Did I put my brother under the bed? It was funny.
Yeah,
okay.
It was funny. All it was right. very funny. Maybe you learned from me.
I think that's absolutely right, Mom.
You learned from me mm-hmm. because I was mm-hmm. the makeup person yes. and everything, you know. Now I'm...
Yes. I'm actually, yes. guys, just getting into makeup now.
Yeah.
Like, prior to doing this video, I did my eyes. I mean, and you know what? I know it's not, you know, guru worthy, but it's what I like, and I'm happy about it. Like, I'm so excited as a grandmother and a mother of two adult children to really be embarking on knowing about concealer and primer. And I never wore eyeshadow. And people always told me, oh, you should wear eyeshadow because your eyes,
your
you know,
eyes were the eyes
your,
that could take yeah. it. Yes, yes,
and,
yes.
and, you know, my eyelashes, they're, you know, I have, these are mine. These are just with yeah. mascara. I don't wear
that's
false
why I used
lashes.
To tell you didn't need makeup because you had these yeah. fabulous eyelashes mm-hmm. and you had these eyes mm-hmm. that were
I love my mother's eyebrows. My mother, you know, growing up, my mom always did her own eyebrows. She plucked them. She always had tweezers. Back in the day, it was tweezers. And her eyebrows have always been on point. Look, they have this saying, Mom, they say your eyebrows are on fleek, which means your eyebrows are real hot. And they are. So, yeah. Okay.
And I don't do anything with them now.
Okay.
I don't do anything now. You know, Ronnie Williams, the comedian in Jamaica, say a habit is a habit. Anywhere you go, you have it. So, where did you have it?
Mommy, say that again for the folks that don't understand patois.
A habit is a habit. Anywhere you go, you have it.
I love that. A habit is a habit. Anywhere you go, you have it.
Did you
yes, honey. Yeah. Well, I guess you don't know any weird habits of mine, but we'll take that saying, yeah. and that's yeah. your patois and, lesson for today,
yes,
folks.
Yes. Yeah. Nail,
that's nice,
and that's your that's like your dad's name. Chinese or what? Any particular? I think
I don't eat Chinese food, so I don't know about that, Ma. That's that might be a little off already because I don't eat Chinese food.
What?
Okay,
really
it's fine if
eat,
yeah, we don't eat out.
Yet, so I
we
really
you know, guys, that's something
yeah.
we hardly
very
ever
seldom,
eat out.
Very seldom.
Only if we're traveling
yeah.
and we'll eat out.
Yeah.
Other than that, we eat home.
Yeah.
We eat home.
Yeah,
yeah that's a good
yeah.
thing.
Yeah. Well, I wish. I think because of your sense of everything and you're so sensible really I probably think you could be a very known person
okay.
because you know you just got into you smart you know what I mean and
so
I
you wish that I would be
you
famous
followed your intuitions of knowing that you know you were really very smart
mm-hmm.
and do something. But then it can still happen.
Like what, Mom? Like, you want me to be famous? Is that what you're saying?
Not so
I don't understand.
Famous, like... I don't know. It's not famous. It's not fame. It's what would it be? It's like... You're just truthful to yourself. You're not going to pretend or... You know, you're going to come out with it, whatever it is.
Have I always been that way?
Always. You would speak your mind and it doesn't matter who gets annoyed, but Jackie's gonna tell you exactly what you are or who you are. That's the truth right there. have to go there.
Yes.
No, we can't go there.
Yes, no, let's go there.
That's not funny.
Let's go there.
I think you're trying to change it around where you become the mother and I become the daughter.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
That's true.
Okay, so I'm being what? More like reversing the roles? Like,
yes,
I think, yes, I'm your mother?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes.
Mm-hmm.
Yes. Okay. And I depend on your, on the things that you advise or the things you say, so it doesn't bother me.
Sometimes only, it annoys,
yes,
you?
Yes, yeah, you know?
I can take it.
Yeah.
I can take it.
I don't think anything bothers you which would apply to our relationship, because we are so together.
But not just our relationship, but in just in like in general.
Hey. Don't let me say it.
Go ahead.
You're paranoid over cleanliness. Just, I'll tell you all a funny story how bad it is. I'm sitting here and I had a gum in my mouth and I thought it was so nice chewing gum. So I said, okay. And I put it next to me on a box. Jackie was restless. She was practically really, Mom. Why'd you put this? Yeah. Your overzealousness about cleanliness. And it's a good thing. I love it.
Mm-hmm.
I love it.
All right, cool. That's heavy. 10 years from now,
I think I would like you to be me at that age.
Mm-hmm.
I had a fantastic, you know, profession, which was just amazing.
You want to see me be you in 10 years from now. I mean,
yes.
I'm not, nobody knows my age because I haven't said it, but they know I have adult children.
Yeah.
I have a son who is, in his 30s. So you want to see me in 10 years be what you were at my age?
Yes. Yes.
But weren't you almost ready to retire?
That was a good thing. No, that was the best time of my life because I really, in my profession, I had become top of the line. It was amazing, you know. And at the time, I was in Jamaica and I was in a very exclusive place. So I met huge people, everybody who you could think of. That, you know, it was just amazing. And I would love that for you because that made my
but Mom, you know, I'm not interested in meeting huge
people. I guess
people,
not. You're right.
And
yeah.
I'm not It's like, I don't know.
But, when
but
I
if
tell,
that's what you wish for me,
but,
that's what
no,
you wish
No, but
when
me. I tell you about them, you're so...
I mean, because I'm happy to know,
that I know
that you,
people,
that made you happy.
Yes.
But I guess what I'm trying to say, Mom, is at this stage of my life, I realize that every last one of us, for the most part, put our undergarment on 1 foot at a time.
Yes.
We all have, you cut any of us out, we're going to bleed red.
Mm-hmm.
And so I know I'm more taken aback by the things of the, you know, things that God has created than I am.
Yeah.
Which the truth is, we are a part of His creation.
Yes.
But I don't idolize anyone.
No, that's the thing. I
used to back in the
because
day.
Because when I would tell you the people I have had relationships with in my profession, you're like, you're happy for me, but
the stories were awesome.
You,
yeah,
you know,
but it didn't matter to me. Yeah.
You know? But
it really doesn't matter now.
Yeah.
But anyway, okay, so what's the next question?
Right now.
Oh, Mommy,
right now, I'm so proud.
Sweet.
I almost felt my head grow because it's so,
so
true.
Sweet.
You've always been a woman, but you become, you know, you're focused and nothing can pass you. You know, you are.
No, thank you.
It's good. I love it.
Thank
I really
you so
love
much,
it. I love
that
it.
Really
yeah.
touched me.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Yeah. You really have more?
Yeah, there's a few more. See where I get the sense of humor from? Mm-hmm.
Worst?
Yes.
Worst?
Yes, Mom, the worst.
when the kids were in the teens, you were losing it at times, I thought. But then I wasn't so used to the teenage business because you and your brother were never the typical teenagers.
Losing it? How?
Like, you couldn't understand if they're not doing anything. Like, they're typical teenagers, mm-hmm. worst teenagers, you know what I mean? And mm-hmm. you always thought they were so more advanced, which was what you were. They were mm-hmm. like you, at the, mm-hmm. you know? Mm-hmm. And you were kind of coming on heavy with it with them, and they're rebelling.
Like, I was very militant?
Militant.
Oh.
Exactly.
Oh, okay. That's
yeah.
okay.
Mm-hmm.
Cool.
Yeah.
I get you.
Yes.
That's right.
Yeah.
Chop.
Do yeah. we have more?
Hit, hit, hit.
Yeah.
Let me start.
Yes, that's you.
That's
yeah,
right.
You,
that's
yeah.
right. How mm-hmm. you doing?
Yeah. We've always been good together, but there's a lot of times that we were not together. Mm-hmm. You know, like I was in Jamaica, you were here and all that. But I think right now, what we have is, mm-hmm. is, it doesn't have a price to it, mm-hmm. or it's just so real, mm-hmm. you know? Mm-hmm. Sometimes you're trying to be the mother, but I'll take mm-hmm. it because, you know, I said, okay, let yeah. her get away, because my mother, I was like that with my mother, so.
Yeah. You know what it is? Yeah. It's just that in the latter time, which yeah. you look so good, people would not even understand, oh, but God. Both my mother yeah. and I, okay. yeah. are undergoing at this particular yeah. time in our lives yeah. a lot of health issues. Yeah. And for many of my subscribers that know my channel, you will know in earlier videos that I've always come to my channel and asked for prayer for my mom whenever she was ill. Yeah. Yeah. It's not a secret that my mom had a massive heart yeah. attack last year, and just to have her sitting next to me now is awesome.
Blessing.
But with that comes, yeah. you know, a lot of tension, because I want what's best for her, and at the same time, she doesn't want to lose her independence. So it becomes kind of, you know, touch and go, you know, yeah. where we would agree to disagree. But the beautiful thing about that is that we're both shooting for the same objective.
Yes, yes,
I want yes. the best for her, and yes. I want her to be happy.
Yeah.
I want her to be most of all healthy, because I need to have her with me.
Yeah.
I would agree yeah. that what my mom said, this is the best time of our lives, yeah. and yeah. it's so beautiful, you know? So, yeah, okay, we only have two more.
The brightest in your class, in your conversations, it was, you know, hey.
Yeah, I got skipped twice, yeah.
Wow. Wow.
Yeah. yeah.
Too intelligent.
Yeah.
Way above her age. You know, it was good.
It's bittersweet, because when you're so smart as a child, I'm sorry, go ahead, Mommy.
Yeah, I think you got that from your father,
mm.
because he always handled you with such, like he was talking to a person his mm-hmm, age. He would mm-hmm. never leave it in a, you know, mm-hmm. make it a less mm-hmm. stress or whatever.
He talked to me so that I could understand. And he didn't talk to me like back in the day, you know. Like, for instance, I remember a story that Daddy told me, and he said that my grandmother, God rest her beautiful soul, she used to talk to us like this. How, Mommy?
No, don't do that.
I'm going to do it. Bunks, banks, lunks, dunks. Bunks,
dunks, banks,
lunks, dunks.
And you know what was so bad about that?
What?
Your daddy.
Yeah, like it. So Daddy was the kind of person that, well, Daddy was just actually, okay, real quick, I'm going to make this really quick. My parents, my mom went to England for a scholarship to do nursing. Okay, so she's a registered nurse, and she did her nursing in England. Which, back in those days, it was the biggest privilege ever to be sent from the Caribbean to the UK to do nursing. It means that you, first of all, had to excel in school. So I got some of it from you too, Mommy. And so when she went to England, she met my dad, and needless to say, they were both champion dancers. So they used to win all types of dance contests while Mommy's still going to school. They're winning contests and fell in love. Lo and behold, they got married. And at 19 and 20 consecutively, my mom and dad were married with a child and Then they had another child shortly thereafter and a home, their own home. They owned a home in the north part of London. For a young couple to have children and to be doing so well, that was awesome.
As a matter of fact, what you don't remember is, remember we were the couple they chose on NBC when we're all getting
right. Yeah, I don't remember the actual thing, but they chose our family to do an interview as immigrants.
Because we had what they wanted. Like I was a student nurse, and
well, you had by that time you were already a registered nurse. But we can't. Okay, well, let me fast because I don't too much. Yeah. We came to the United States, and when we went back to the UK to get our paperwork and everything settled, they asked us, my mom, if they could interview my mom and dad, if they could interview our family as an immigrant family and how professionals go to the, immigrant families, which have, quote unquote professions, go to the United States. So I said all of that to say my grandmother was going to spend time. My grandparents were spending time with them. So here it is. Daddy doesn't want to step on her toes because she said, langsy, donksy, bunks, donks. She's holding me. And her donks, fancy, longsy, bunks. And my father would cringe because he did not want me to think lunks, danks, bunksy, dunks was the language. Yes, yes. So finally, he ended up saying to her, Mom, could you please speak to my daughter properly so she can learn? And he was nervous, but Grandma, she respected it. She had to love him, honey. That little 5'2" woman would have sent him packing, honey. But she didn't do that. So so that's why I went into all that long segue. Yeah. Last question, and it is...
Nothing. I really wouldn't. Nothing.
Wait, I just want to say thank you, Mommy.
It's a pleasure.
Thank you for doing this video with me. And now you can you can take a saw off your hair now.
No, I can't.
You know how it is when somebody's not used to being on a camera. My mother is so cute. She's like,
I'm natural. I'm looking at you and I'm smiling because, this is my daughter. I'm proud. I'm very happy.
You proud because I'm doing a YouTube video? Huh? You proud why? Because I'm doing a YouTube video?
No, I'm proud of you for everything. Oh, okay. So,
I'm glad you are.
Yeah,
I'm glad. Today ended up being a better day than it started out. Later, guys. Yes. I love each and every one of you for free. And this is the mom that many of you have prayed for over the years.
Thank you. Thanks for the prayers. We almost forgot that.
Yeah.
Thanks. I heard that in Jamaica, every church was praying for me when I got ill. And I thought that was really good because I've looked after so many people. Even if they're not in the hospital, I find home where they are because they're my mother's friends or whatever. And I became this, this person that everybody was sort of, fond of. So you're going the right route. You are.
Thank you, Mom. All right, guys.
It was a pleasure.
All right, guys.
The questions weren't as bad as I thought.
No, they weren't. So now you can be released.
Thank you.
You are now released.
Bye, guys.
Oh, we go like this. Peace. Mm-hmm. Peace. And love.
Later. Bye-bye.